Welcome to Information Service Engineering. This is lecture number 2, Natural Language Processing, part 1. So, what are we going to do in this type of lecture? First of all, we have to clarify what is natural language processing. So, we will tell you about NLP and how does NLP relate to artificial intelligence. So, you will see and learn that NLP is part of artificial intelligence. And we will see that also other disciplines like, for example, phonetics or phonology are part of NLP. However, we will not talk about or go in details about phonetics and phonology since we are focusing on text. However, before starting with any technology, we will talk about basic linguistics and we have to learn how languages are constructed. So we will hear about phones and phonemes, which are the smallest units of speech utterances that might carry meaning. We will talk about what is a word in a language, and if we put several words together, what's a vocabulary, and overall then, what makes a language? What is a language? So we will see that words are the smallest units in a language that carry meaning and are independent, so they can be placed in different places in sentences, for example, but they have usually a fixed meaning. And how these words are constructed, this usually in linguistics will be dealt with in the subject of morphology. So morphology is the study of words, how they are formed, and their relationship to other words in the same language. So we will learn that words here are built from smaller units, the so-called morphemes, and we will distinguish between free morphemes, which are single, small, short words, and so-called bound morphemes, which themselves, they are not words, they are parts of words that don't have meaning on their own, but they can be used to extend and combine words together. So we will see how this works together with prefixes and suffixes, for example. And how to create exactly these kind of new compound words. There are specific morphological rules. So we will learn about derivation rules. We will learn about compounding, how to, create new words out of several existing words, and inflection, which is then also we are changing somehow the word by, in English is it via affixation, to somehow change a bit of the meaning and to express, let's say, for example, a specific time or to express a specific number. So this you can do via inflection. And since we can change these words, we also must have a normalized form of these words. And how to get to this root or the stem of a word? This is done by stemming. And how to find a lemma, which is a lexicon or a dictionary form? This is done via lemmatization. So we will briefly talk about that in our morphology chapter. Then we will have a broad look on potential applications and we will see how NLP is used in OCR, so in optical character recognition, as well as in information retrieval, word prediction, text classification, sentiment analysis, but also in rather important stuff like speech recognition and speech synthesis and dialogue systems, as you are dealing with on a daily basis, for example, with your intelligent and smart agents that you have today. And after we see how NLP is applied, we also focus on specific techniques in NLP that, of course, try to analyze, let's say, the structure of texts. First of all, we try to analyze the structure of a longer text by breaking it down in sentences, breaking it down in single tokens. And then we want to find out what's the purpose of these tokens. You do this usually by part of speech tagging. Or we want to find out, what is the entire structure of a sentence by constituency parsing or dependency parsing. And then we want to find out what's the meaning of the single word. So what's the word category? So is it a person? Is it, let's say, a place, a time, an organization? This is done by named entity recognition. And if you want to find out even more, if you want to link a specific word, a surface form, to an entity in a knowledge base, which exactly explains what the word is, this is then entity linking or named entity resolution. And we will see several other techniques like semantic row labeling or coreference resolution, which also are part of NLP techniques. And right in the end, so that this is not only, let's say, a complete theoretical lecture. We also have prepared for you a small collaborative notebook that you can use, and there you can simply try out tokenization and all the other techniques we have briefly spoken about here in a Python-based notebook. Okay, so that's our plan for the lecture. So I hope you will enjoy the lecture and have a good start. And first, we start with what is natural language processing.